What's up, guys? This is Jessica, and welcome to Critic. We are doing a talk series. In these series, you'll learn the basic toxidromes, the ABC assessment of the intoxicated, toxicokinetics, and there are also videos coming up on common drug overdoses. So keep coming back. In this kickoff video, we'll go through the general steps of assessing and treating acute drug poisoning. Now, let's get into it. When dealing with a poisoned patient, there are four steps to go through. The most important thing to remember is to treat the patient first and not the poison. So you begin with the ABCDE assessment to determine their general condition and to treat first what kills first. We'll go through this in a separate video. Next, you try and name the toxidrome. Toxidromes are a collection of symptoms that reflect drug class effect. Toxidromes help you in figuring out what drugs to look for and to anticipate for problems to come. We'll go through the different toxidromes in the next couple of videos. Then you move on to your secondary survey. For the poison patient, this mainly consists of risk assessment concerning the specific drugs. This is what your pharmacist will want to know. What did they take? How much did they take? When did they take it? Etc. Also assess specific patient factors that could influence pharmacokinetics. Watch my introductory series if you haven't yet. How did they ingest a drug? What's their body weight? Are they on any other medication that could interact with said drug? Any liver or kidney diseases, etc.? Remember that oftentimes your patient will not be able to answer these questions or won't answer them truthfully. To quote Dr. House, everybody lies, which is especially the case when it comes to the intoxicated. And finally, you move on to general treatment of poisoning. I can't stress enough that during your ABCDE assessment, you should have already started symptomatic treatment. General treatment of poisoning consists of four considerations. The fantastic website called Life in the Fast Lane has endearingly named DEAD: decontamination, enhanced elimination, antidotes, and disposition. Decontamination. The goal of decontamination is to decrease or delay absorption. For the skin or the eye, this obviously means rigorous rinsing. For orally ingested drugs, this includes gastric lavage, the administration of active charcoal, and whole bowel irrigation. Your first thought should be if there is a contraindication toward these forms of decontamination. Your next thought should be if there is an indication toward these forms of decontamination, i.e., what's the chance that it will be effective, which obviously depends on the ingested drug. Gastric lavage used to be routinely used, but nowadays usage is more reserved. Gastric lavage is performed by inserting a gastric tube, placing the patient onto their left side, pylorus pointing up, and flushing the tube with 300 cc of water or normal saline. Note that there are various ways of doing this, and this is just one. It is contraindicated if the patient has ingested corrosive materials like acids or volatile substances like petroleum, as this increases the risk of aspiration. Patient-specific contraindications include a decreased level of consciousness or agitation, or ABC instability. Gastric lavage is only effective when performed early after ingestion, so there is an indication for gastric lavage within 1 hour of ingestion, and it can be considered within 4 hours of ingestion, depending on the drug. Activated charcoal is used as a binding agent to prevent absorption. It is performed by mixing the charcoal with water and letting the patient either drink this or by administering it over a gastric tube after gastric lavage. Typical dose is 50 grams. Contraindications are absent bowel movements or ileus, gastrointestinal hemorrhage, and if your patient is non-cooperative. Beware when administering activated charcoal in patients with reduced levels of consciousness, as they could aspirate. Activated charcoal is only effective in certain drugs and when performed early after ingestion. We usually say within the hour. Activated charcoal is not effective for metals like iron or alcohol. Whole bowel irrigation is used when there are drugs involved that don't bind to activated charcoal or with slow-release preparations. It decreases the transit time of the ingested drug. It is performed by ingesting 3 to 6 liters of polyethylene glycol, either by having the patient drink this or by a nasogastric tube. Contraindications are the same as in activated charcoal, i.e. absent bowel movements or ileus, or gastrointestinal hemorrhage, as the volume load is a lot higher for whole bowel irrigation than it is for activated charcoal. It should not be performed in unconscious or uncooperative patients. Consider intubating if necessary. Enhanced elimination. There are three common ways for enhanced drug elimination. The first is by applying multiple doses of activated charcoal. This interrupts the enterohepatic circulation. Note that it is only effective in drugs that have profound biliary excretion. Common ones include theophylline, phenobarbital, dapsone, carbamazepine, and quinine, which can be remembered by the following phrase: these people drink charcoal quickly. Please note that multiple dose activated charcoal requires the addition of laxatives as it could cause constipation. Too much laxatives, however, decrease the effectiveness of your treatment. The second way of enhanced drug elimination is alkalinizing the urine. Ionized molecules are more water-soluble than their non-ionized counterparts. Non-ionized molecules, on the other hand, are better at crossing cell membranes. I talk about this in my absorption video. You can imagine that if a drug is filtered through the glomerulus of the kidney, it'd be great if we were able to keep that drug from crossing the tubule back into our circulation. This is accomplished by making the urine more alkaline with sodium bicarbonate, as this ionizes weak acids like aspirin and phenobarbital, keeping it in urine and out of our bloodstream. For more information, check out my video on excretion. Aim for a urine pH of 7.5 and a serum pH between 7.45 and 7.55. Beware of hypokalemia. The third way of enhanced elimination encompasses extracorporeal techniques. The most well-known are hemodialysis and hemofiltration. The exact mechanisms are beyond the scope of this video. Notable toxins that can be eliminated this way are isopropanol, salicylates, theophylline, uremia, methanol, barbiturates, lithium, and ethylene glycol. Antidotes. In the coming videos, you'll learn more about specific antidotes for specific drugs. Disposition. After stabilizing your patient, you're not done yet. Your patient needs to be admitted to an environment capable of providing an appropriate level of monitoring and supportive care. Consider medium or intensive care admission. And last, but definitely not least, your patient needs psychiatric evaluation and follow-up. Okay, so that's for the general treatment of poisoning. Now let's hop into the series. Subscribe for immediate notifications. If you like these videos, give them a like or a share. See you in the next one.